Hello everyone, thank you so much for coming back. These are going to be videos, or I should say readings, for April 2016. I want to say special welcome to all my returning subscribers. Thank you so much for subscribing, for watching. Thank you all for your wonderful comments and feedback, and texts as well, and emails. I appreciate it more than you will ever know. So thank you, and keep watching. Thank you so much for new viewers and new subscribers. Thank you for giving your time and taking chance on these videos, and I hope that you will get to enjoy these videos as much as all the other subscribers have up until this point. Let's start with April. It's a beautiful sunny day. I feel April is going to be a fantastic month for a lot of you. I think for some of you, March was a little bit iffy. Energies were shifting and people were going through a lot of changes. I do feel that April looks much brighter for most of you, majority of you, if not all of you. So let's get started with the reading. And again, thank you so much for watching. Please comment. Please email me if you like. Please text me with your comments. And also please remember that these are general readings. They will not apply to everyone every single time. And if they don't apply to you in some months, go and look at your different, your other signs, as these may apply to you much more than your sun sign. I find that clients or people who watch often say that when they listen to their other signs, it makes much more sense to them. So feel free to do that and let me know if it works for you. Okay, without further ado, let's get started. Hello and welcome back. Let me just adjust a little bit. This is going to be a reading for Pisces, for the sign of Pisces, for the month of April 2016. Thank you so much for coming back. I asked my guide to give me any messages before I proceed with the reading. And the first thing I heard was the word grandmother. And this, when I heard this, I know that for some of you, I am supposed to say that a grandmother in spirit is looking out for you. I am being drawn towards a female. That doesn't mean that this isn't a message for a male, but I am being drawn towards a female. So perhaps this is one of those rare instances that this message is for one particular person and you're going to know who you are the moment you hear it. And I get that actually on few occasions, and I always think that that's very special. The other thing, so your grandmother wants you to know that you are not alone. Okay, the message for the rest of you is you're not alone, despite the fact that you may feel this way at this particular moment. I am also hearing the word upheaval. So for some of you, you have gone through a time in your life where one could call it an upheaval, something that wasn't easy and certainly something that wasn't overly pleasant. And you are to know that you are always being looked after, even though you may not realize it here on the physical plane or in the physical plane. You're not alone, you're not alone, you're not alone. That is the message that I am being asked to give to whoever this is for. Okay, now I always say, hopefully the cards will corroborate what I just said, because that makes it that much more special, because I don't see the cards before I flip them over. So let's start. In a position of present, we have the card called Light. This is a major arcana card, and I believe it's sun in a traditional tarot deck, but please don't quote me because I'm terrible when it comes to cards. I actually don't know how to read cards properly, as I'm sure you've heard before. I just listen to what's being said to me. But this card is shown to me in reverse. And what this is saying to me is that life is not feeling very bright right now. And this is due to some unfortunate circumstances that you have gone through in the last eight. It could be 8 weeks, 8 months, 8 years, maybe even 8 days. But things are not feeling like they're looking up right now, or things are not feeling very bright, which is probably why you're being told you're not alone, and a grandmother energy comes through and says, you are not alone. Even though you feel that way, you are not alone. So that's what the card represents as of the current situation. Past influences is represented by standing your ground. So this tells me right off the bat that you had recently left a situation where you had to put your foot down. Perhaps you are that woman, that female, who has left an abusive relationship. And this doesn't necessarily mean relationship of a romantic nature. It could be relationship with a friend, a coworker, a partner, a work partner, a business partner, anything that you felt was undermining you. And those are the words that I'm hearing. So that's in your past, and that's shedding the light on why you're not feeling like you're in a great place right now. And maybe that's why you're feeling like you were alone, because you had to say stop to some kind of situation that has been going on for quite some time. And I hear the word perpetuating. So this was a situation that kept occurring over and over and over again. And eventually you said, you know, I've had enough. So whether you had to leave, somebody had to leave, or something of that sort. And I do hear the word broken heart. So this means to me that the decision that was made, whether on your part or somebody else's part, was met with a heavy heart. Nonetheless, you are not alone. This will pass. This is a very small part of your life. You are at a juncture right now. That's the word I'm hearing. And you are about to enter a new phase in your existence, a new phase in your life, and whatever happened, whatever you left, had to take place in order for the new doors to open. In other words, certain doors had to be closed, even though it didn't feel comfortable, in order for new doors to open up for you in the very near future. And I hear the word summer. Okay, so feels like summer is going to be much brighter, not only because it's summer and typically we have more sun in the summer, but this is metaphorically speaking, summer is going to be a more joyful time in your life. Some of you asked me if I'm feeling okay because I'm sounding kind of sickly. I've just been talking a lot. I've been working pretty much 7 days a week, reading every single day from morning to night. So I'm fine, but if I sound a little bit raspy, that's why. Okay? Now, the card that represents your future, we have the card called Patience and Planning. This is a card that's representative of the earth energies or the physical aspect of who we are. This card was shown to me in reverse. So what this is saying to me is that going forward, you may feel a little bit of hastiness. And when I talk about hastiness, I want to talk about impatience. So you will be feeling like you want things to progress quicker. However, what I'm being told is that whatever you're going through right now cannot be rushed, cannot be skipped, cannot be put aside and not dealt with. It is a process you have to go through, and you are being asked to be patient and to plan accordingly. Please don't jump into any relationships. Please don't jump into any new situations hastily. Please consider your decisions and consider your choices, because I'm being told you do not want to find yourself in the same position that you just came from, okay? So whoever this applies to, and of course this is a general reading, I feel you will know exactly what I'm talking about. And if that does make sense, I would love your comments. So that's in the future. The reason behind all of this, we have the card called Suffering in Silence. This is a card that represents your thinking. your emotions, yes, but it's your thinking process. And what this is saying to me is that the reason why all of this is taking place, the reason why you have to stand your ground, and the reason why you are left a certain situation or left certain people, and the reason why you're not feeling like things are too bright right now, is because you left a situation where, for the most part, I'm being told you are unable to speak. Not because you don't have the ability to speak. Maybe for some of you, that is the case. But I am more drawn towards saying that there was an inability for you to stand up for yourself, which is probably why you eventually said, you know what, I've had it. And I want control back. So that is the reason behind all of this. This can signify that you have left a situation that was in some way abusive. It may be physically, I heard financially, in some monetary way, emotionally, mentally, or all of the above. And I feel like you've been in it for quite some time, and there was a reluctance for you to speak up, and you endured basically a lot of suppressing a lot of your emotions and a lot of your feelings and a lot of your thoughts. So this is just shedding light on why we're dealing with what we're dealing right now. The potential that has the possibility of opening up in front of you. Is that the right way of saying it? The potential from all of this is financial and material changes. So this is a card that represents the physical aspect of who we are. Five to me represents changes, and I hear major changes. Now, financial and material changes, this can talk about moving homes. It could talk about exchanging money or money changing hands. Perhaps you will be dividing possessions. Perhaps you will be getting money from someone. You will be paying money to somebody. There is some changes going on. However, I do not feel these changes are debilitating. I do feel that they may feel slightly uncomfortable at the beginning. I do feel that it is a situation that you will eventually get used to. And I heard the word alimony. Perhaps some of you will be paying alimony. Perhaps some of you will be receiving alimony. Whatever the word alimony, whoever this applies to, you will know what I mean. And though it may feel a little bit uncomfortable at the beginning, I do not feel it is going to profoundly change you or change your life in a negative way. I do feel it's something you will have to get used to, and I do feel that it's something you will get used to, and you will move past it and just consider it as being part of your life. So I'm not sure exactly what it is that I'm talking about. I just heard the word financial settlement. So there's definitely things connected to finances and money. If you are leaving a relationship and there is children involved, maybe there is an exchange of money for child support or spousal support. If you are leaving a situation connected to work, perhaps you will be compensated for something, and perhaps it's not going to be a compensation that you hoped for, but it's not going to be substantially worse. So I do feel grounded with this, but I do feel a bit of, you wish it was better, okay? Maybe you're hoping for more money from alimony or child support, and you're not going to get as much as you think, or maybe reverse, you're going to pay, and it's going to be more than you think. Nonetheless, what you are to know is that all is well. You will get used to it. This will not have major impact on you going forward. It's just a part of life. Okay? Now, let me just see if there is anything else he wants me to say. Again, I'm hearing the words, you're not alone. And whoever this applies to, I certainly feel that you feel like you are alone, and you feel like you have no support, or that people cannot possibly understand what you are going through. You do have people in spirit, and I get this grandmother figure who is right behind you and understands everything you are going through and experiencing. And I'm being told to say this, I don't often say it in readings on YouTube, but I'm being told that they are sending you their love and they're trying to comfort you, particularly when you're sleeping. So if you do have dreams of loved ones who are passed, know that more often than not, your loved ones are visiting you while you're in a dream state, because your analytical part of you is resting and is not interfering, so you're not questioning. Okay, I hope this makes sense. It's not, I don't consider myself giving negative readings. I've never had. I do understand that some readings are not as happy as others, but that's life. And if I only gave you happy news, then I wouldn't be realistic. I believe that my messages are meant to help you cope. They're meant to help you understand. They're meant to help you evolve and change and progress and grow. And sometimes when you are dealing with challenges and spirit gives you information to help you push you forward and to say, listen, it is okay, I feel that I need to give you that message. So though it's not the lightest reading I have given this month, however, I do feel that whatever changes you are undergoing are changes that are way overdue and changes that are most definitely sending you in a right direction. Okay, and I'm being told the path is clear in front of you, but don't let your head or your thinking get in the way of what's coming to you. I also hear the word doubts, so perhaps you are filled with doubts, and if you are,